obvious that they love each other. So together, this is truly a blessed moment in the eyes of God. And as we journey through this liturgy, I'd ask that you listen carefully to the readings they chose, as well as the music that will be shared, and the very powerful words they will be exchanging. Commitment for love, steadfastness, which we're all going to witness today. So my friends, let us pray. Come and actually, the church shares your joy and warmly welcomes you, together with your families and friends, as today, in the presence of God and the Father, you establish between yourselves lifelong partnership. May the Lord hear you on this beautiful and joyful day. May he send you help from heaven and always protect you and your love. May he grant you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your prayers. And we ask this in Christ's name.
Amen.
And if you can turn your Bible into your chairs. And Arthur, if you can come forward, we are going to have a liturgy of the word, and our community may be seated.
A reading from the book of Genesis, 2:18-24. That's a good call. Thank you. Bad start, I'll start again. A reading from the book of Genesis, 2:18-24. The Lord God said, "It's not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air. And he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, all the wild animals, but none proved to be suitable partner for the man. So the Lord cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of the ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman. For out of her man, this one has been taken." That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife. And the two of them become one body. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
today, take it from the New Testament, where it will be proclaimed at John.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love. Not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God. Yet, if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. The word of the Lord.
So, my friends, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Now when Jesus saw the crowds, he went up to the mountain. And after he had sat down, his disciples came to be with him. And he began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. And blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. And blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown great mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. And blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. And blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord, everyone. Amen. Please be seated, everyone. You know, it's always such a joy to preside and be witness of a marriage between friends, a marriage between individuals who are deeply in love with each other. I want to thank our couple for allowing me to be here today. And we have some great friends. I look back and I said, this is a rowdy crowd. I don't know. But you're going to have a great day today. But I want to thank you first and foremost, because I know there were many options for a young couple preparing for marriage. You could certainly go on a destination marriage, or you could end up where a JP office, or wherever. But you chose this church because you are a witness that you want God to be part of your life. You want God to bless your family. You want God to journey with you in good times and bad, in sickness and health. You want him to be an intimate member of your life. And that's pretty remarkable. It's pretty amazing to you. So again, I thank you for that. You know, we're going to say that word love a lot today. And I know as a society, we love to throw it out there. You know, we love everything. You know, one more time we're saying how we love our children. We love our children. children. And the next, we love chicken orzo soup, you know? They kind of equate all this stuff. But the church actually looks at that meaning of love. And, you know, when you went to your pre-K class, do you remember the name of the book? Okay, fantastic. That's all I have. Isn't so much an emotion as it is an action, a commitment, a desire. And so I love the title of that book because it's saying, in the good times and bad, you choose to love your wife, you choose to love your husband. You know, and that's what gets people to that 50 years of marriage, you know, is when they're able to do that, make that hard decision. But again, the church looks at that word love, and it has actually 4 points about love, and I'd like to just look at those, if I may, and see how you do them, all right? And if you want any of them, well, we'll see what happens, all right? The first is that love is freely given. It is free. And I know that the two of you are very much involved, and you know, our pre-marital inventory, I asked you that question privately. Are you freely choosing to love? They both said yes. Are you freely choosing to love? Because no one for true love can force you to love. No one can arrange you to love. No one can coerce you. It has to come from inside. And you freely choose to love this man, and you freely choose to love this beautiful woman. And I know from my heart that you have done that. I know you have done that. And so, one of them. All right, second, that it is total. That love has to be total. That you give not only your heart, but your mind, your body, and your soul. Love is a total commitment of who you are. You know, we don't want someone to love us for as long as we don't put on weight, or we lose our hair, or we get old, or we get ill. You know, you are nurses. You know what happens in relationships when one of those parties has to face a debilitating disease. Love conquers that, you know? It has to be total in your mind, in your heart, and in your soul. And I know that you have that type of love, that you are committed completely to one another. Well done. And then, of course, faith, that you intend to make this your life partner, your life friendship, through all the seasons of your life, that your heart belongs only to this person, and that it will be held faithfully in this union. And you know, each day, in order to keep that, because the world is tough. The world is tough on marriage. It's not always easy on you. And there's all kinds of distractions, all kinds of things that will lure you away from this beautiful covenant. And you know, one of the ways that you keep it solid and strong and long-lasting is every morning, you know, when you get up to go brush your teeth, simply say, Lord, bless our marriage. I mean, what a short prayer. But it's powerful and it's important. And don't ever forget, because I was just talking to a couple. I just blessed their 50th year of marriage. And when I did, I mentioned how I say that to our young couples. And I said, Father, every morning you say that prayer. You say that prayer. God bless our marriage. And that also pulls God back in and reminds you that there's a three individual couple. You need God and each other. All right? Amen. So be faithful and pray for that faithfulness. It's so important. And certainly, the last mark of true love is that it bears fruit. And it can bear fruit, certainly, in the friendship that you have with your family, with your careers, your work. That love does produce wonderful things all around you. Because when people, you know, when people are surrounded by something that positive, they're attracted to that. and they are drawn to that. And you are very sure of what this covenant means. So realize that there's fruit there. But it also, we pray, is fruitful that you become mom and dad. I mean, what greater gift would that be? The two of you, with all that you have to give, all of your gifts, and time, and talent, and love, you would be such wonderful parents. So I pray for all of my little Billy, Mary, and folks that one day God blesses them, and they can hear that word. Hey, mom! Hey, dad! What's for supper? You know? There's no more beautiful music than that. So I pray for that, for you. You know, another thing, as a people of faith, we look to Jesus always as what love means. And that's why we still have that crucifix in our church. That was back in 1854. It's the only thing that survived in the church burning. And I think it's a strong message to us that love is sacrificial, that we are called to love someone more than we love ourselves, that just like Christ loves all of you, and that we are a sacrifice, just like Christ sacrificed out of love for all of us. Your marriage needs putting her needs and your needs before our love. You know, and when you do that, wow, something really powerful. Genesis today, in that powerful book, it talks about finding that one person that you think God intends you to have. And I think you have done that. So cherish that, support that, you know, give the gifts in this marriage that will make that love grow. You know, friendship, patience, forgiveness, love, and certainly the gift of creativity. Also, you know, as you start this union, you know, I admire so much what you do in your life, in your career. You know, so many new relationships and marriages don't have to face all that you had to face in 2020 and 2021 as being people in the profession of health, of love, of sacrifice. You know, I know. That's why when I was looking at those points, I said, look at what they've done to complete strangers, people you didn't even know. You put yourself in harm's way because you are called to love, not only in your little circle, but beyond. The world admires your career. The world admires your sacrifice. The world admires all that you've done for us. And in the eyes of God, you know, He is so proud of you. And I know He's going to bless you abundantly for all the sacrifices that you've already given this week. So selfless, I think, a very little to find. So my friends, may God bless our married couple, and may your love be freely given, may it be total in nature, faithful in commitment, and may it bear great, great fruit. Amen. Even though they don't know where it's all going to be. Okay, my friends, why don't I have you to come out here, please? I think at one time I had to say to you, do I need to call you mom? I need those readings. All right. Okay, I'm going to have you face me first, all right? And then we're going to ask this one. Then I'll just step aside and let you pass. Okay? Dearly beloved, you have come together in the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with the sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, He enriches and strengthens those He has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church,
I ask you now to state your intention. So Ashley, Tom, have you come here to enter into marriage freely and wholeheartedly?
I have.
And are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
I am.
And are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
I am.
Beautiful. And since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, I ask that you face one another, join your hands, and declare your consent before God and His church. So Tom, we're going to meet with you, all right? Okay. Repeat after me. I, Thomas.
Take you, Ashley.
To be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. To love you. And honor you. All the days of my life.
I, Ashley.
Take you, Thomas. To be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health. To love you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life. Bless the rings that you will place on your fingers. Bless them with holy water.
Oh, slide, not easy.
May the Lord bless these rings, which you will give to each other as a sign of your great love and fidelity. So why don't you take Ashley's one? Okay, place the ring. And repeat after me, okay? Ashley.
Receive this ring.
As a sign of my love. And fidelity. In the name of the Father. And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Place the ring. Repeat after me. Thomas.
Receive this ring.
As a sign of my love. And fidelity. In the name of the Father. And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
May place the ring on his finger.
It's on.
You may kiss your bride, you may kiss your groom, and you may open. Also, for our bride and groom, may their love deepen and grow
as the years go by. May they find comfort in each other's arms, support in each other's eyes, and strength in the journey that they walk together. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord.
We also remember all of your loved ones who may have passed away, for they are with you this day. We pray certainly that their memories live on in all of your hearts. May you find comfort in sharing their stories with them with each other, and may you find peace in knowing that they are in the company of God. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord.
And Heavenly Father, you have chosen us, and you have given us your love. Hear and answer our prayers. May our faith lead us to action. May our love show itself indeed. And may our hope give us courage. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. You all may be seated, please. And if Gloria and Tom could please come go to the back of the church, bring forth the gifts, and present them to our bride.
Thank you.
Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon the flame of the people, so that they may become for us body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. For at the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread and gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat up, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice and once more gave thanks and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of
those
Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to the Lord that on these his servants, now married in Christ, he may mercifully pour out the blessing of his grace and make of one heart in love those he has joined by a holy covenant. O God, by your mighty power, created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, you formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might no longer be two, but they now become one. And you taught that what you will please to make one must never be divided. Look now in favor on these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your will and blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit, and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of love and peace abide in your daughter and passion, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung throughout Scripture. May her husband Thomas entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and as his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these, your servants, hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments, staying one in the flesh. May they be blameless in everything they do, and with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all, and grant that, reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they hope, they may come to the light of the blessed and the kingdom of heaven. And we ask this, Christ our Lord. Amen. And the peace of our Lord will be with you always.
With your spirit.
You may exchange that sign of peace with your bride. Okay? Peace, everyone.
Thank you.
please stand with me. Good gracious Lord, as we gather together as a family, as friends, to celebrate this beautiful union, we give you thanks for the gift of love, the love in your heart and the love in this married couple's heart. We pray that you bless them abundantly, Lord, with the gifts that will make them prosper. Bless their families, bless their friends. May you all be great witnesses of the love of God. And may Almighty God bless your union, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Mass is ended. Let us go.